I'm going to give you a tutorial on installing Novacut because I haven't done that for a while. And then I'm also going to walk you through some new things new in Novacut 13.05. So to install Novacut, you'll have to add our PPA. And the easiest way to do that is to open a terminal and type sudo apt. And you can use the tab key to fill the command in so you don't have to type as much. So it's apt-add-repository. And then our PPA is PPA:Novacut/stable. And then hit enter, enter your password, hit enter to confirm. And now you'll need to run sudo apt-get update. If you don't do this, it won't be able to find Novacut because it won't have the updated package list yet. And now sudo apt-get install Novacut. Yes, install some stuff. So it's a touch of a pain, but that's just until we get into a more official channel. And the good thing about this is after you add our PPA, you will automatically get each monthly release we make. So you never have to do this again. Okay, so that's done, close that. So, the first time you run Dmedia or Novacut, doesn't matter which, we'll go to Dmedia because we need to ingest some stuff, you'll see this. So Dmedia will sync your library between your different computers you own. So for example, if you have a laptop that you use in the field, maybe you're a wedding photographer or DIT, and then you come home, you have a workstation where you do your editing, all you have to do is turn on both systems and Dmedia will sync them. So on the first system you've run this, you click new account. On second and third and so on, you click connect to devices and there's this little peering process that takes you through. So new account. This is Dmedia's very important social contract. And we take this very seriously. And these three promises basically kind of drive all of our design and engineering decisions. And that's also why Dmedia has taken a long time to get to what we call production ready, meaning we think it's safe to use for high value assets, because data safety is something you can't fake and also something that you want to actually work. So anyway, when you open Dmedia, the first thing you'll need to do to do any ingest is create a project. So I'll call this Dmedia 13.05. Oops, can't type. And when you create the project, it starts the importer. So you can see the importer is running because there's this little Dmedia indicator up here. And for someone used to kind of more casual desktop focused ingest, this is going to seem strange, but this is designed for high volume, extremely repetitive ingests on a film set especially. So once you start the importer, any cards you insert, or even removable hard drives, doesn't matter, Dmedia will automatically import everything from those cards with no user interaction. And again, when you're doing this over and over and over, this design is the right approach. You also can shove as many as you want in parallel. I only have one card handy at the moment, but so the idea is, you do it in a batch where you shove 4, 5, 6, however many your card readers can take in at once, go to something else because your time is valuable. And then when it's done, when all the card readers are done, Dmedia will prompt you with a single notification. And also, a lot of times you'd be doing something else, not watching a progress bar. And you can see when the importer is active, it's orange. And that means, it's reading from the card readers. When it's back to gray, it means it's safe to pull the card readers out. So you could be, say, editing in Novacut. What did I do there? You know, because you have work to do, don't want to watch progress bars, and then there's this notification, you know, to catch your eye if you happen to be at your computer. But also, if you weren't, you can see that the indicator goes back to orange. This is Novacut. This, you know, our storyboard UI is, that's very close to how it's probably going to remain. This is just a stupid stopgap that I whipped up so people could use it, and will go away. So you can drag stuff around. That's the doodle. This is the sequence. You can move back and forth between as you kind of, you know, play. All about making play inviting and safe, so you do more of it. If you hold your mouse wheel over the starting end of the frame and roll it, it'll do frame by frame steps. If you hold shift mouse wheel, it'll step 10 frame increments. You can do that when it's up here also. This does real-time collaboration with a native app. Something that no one else can do right now, which is awesome. To render, you click over here. So, to render in the background, you have to have Novacut open. So you can see our project finished. If you go over here, this is just kind of stopgap stuff too. Look at that, 33.7 megabytes a second over USB 2. Wow, Dmedia must really ingest fast. Anyway, so now we're going to get a little geeky, because the most important things Dmedia does kind of invisible and in the background, and that's the point. So Dmedia doesn't just sync between your devices, it maintains data safety. So for your precious files that can't be replaced, Dmedia always tries to maintain three copies, and by copies we mean on separate physical drives. So, somewhat, because that's the way it's always going to be, but we will eventually add a way to visualize more of this easily, but right now, basically, all you can do is watch the log files. So, like I said, it's going to get a little geeky. And you can think of Dmedia kind of like a really smart RAID array that spans all of your devices, and even works with, say, removable drives when they're not connected. So there's a lot of things that there's not UI for yet, and that was somewhat deliberate just because I didn't want Dmedia to seem finished from an end-user perspective yet, because I didn't want people to have the wrong idea about our data safety guarantees. So that drove people crazy, but I think that was the right thing to do. Render just completed. This is kind of a stopgap, but it puts the renders in a Novacut folder. So yeah, render, blah, blah, blah. Didn't really edit anything, so it's crappy. Anyway, so very shortly, probably next month, the process of, say, telling Dmedia to use a removable drive as a new place to store files will be there, but I just didn't want to add it until Dmedia was done, basically, under the hood. So, command line again, if you do Dmedia CLI stores, it'll show the currently connected file stores. And normally, that means a drive. So, the kind of unit of storage Dmedia works with is entire drives at a time. Like, it can care less about folders, you know, except to find the mount point of the drive. The one place where that's not totally true is that by default you will have a file store in your user's home directory, so that'll typically be on, you know, your system drive, depending on how you partitioned, but probably your system drive. So right now there's one, and I have a 1 terabyte, oops, plug it in, removable USB drive, so I just plug that in. Yeah, see some stuff in the log file. Not a file store, skipping. Okay. So we're going to turn it into a file store. So it's Dmedia CLI, create file store, and then you just give it the mount point where the drive's at. So that's where it is. So as I was saying, Dmedia tries to maintain three copies of everything. So we just did ingest, and there's only one file store, so there's only one copy. I'm gonna create a file store. Dmedia will add that into the pool, and you'll see in this log file here on the right, immediately Dmedia will see, oh, I've got files with only one copy, or sorry, files with only, one copy, and here's a new place I can put them, so I'm going to fix that. And watch how fast it does it. So create file store, blah, blah, blah. Boom. So copied from .localshare Dmedia to media Novacut Dmedia. So this is the data safeguarding that Dmedia does. Not only will it do this, you know, among the locally connected storage, it'll do it between your devices, which I'll show you in a second once this is done. And now if you do Dmedia CLI stores, you'll see that there's two in there now. So you'll see here, it says 44 copies with, or sorry, 44 files with copies equals two. And Dmedia's not happy yet. It's only happy once there's at least copies equals three. Another handy command is this Dmedia CLI peers. So it'll show your peer devices on the local that are on the local network. So what I'm gonna do, it's hard to capture in the screencast, but my workstation, I'll reach over there and click connect to devices rather than new account. So I'm doing that right now, watch. So we got this peering offer over here. So you click on the peering offer, accept, and then it's gonna display this one-time code. It's not a password, you don't remember this. So you peer these devices now, so they're both part of your library. And immediately you see, again, watching the log file, it's not super action-packed, but it's how you see stuff right now. Oh, and also if you go look at Dmedia CLI peers, there's my workstation. So you'll see it was starting the CouchDB sync. That's okay. The real-time replication that CouchDB can do is very fundamental to how Dmedia works. And you see again, you know, we still have 44 files with copies equals two. So now what's happening? Is my workstation is downloading file by file these files. And it's going to bring it up to three copies for everything. And again, happened instantly. Actually, if not for doing the peering, it would happen even quicker. And you know, so something else that would work if you don't necessarily have to transfer the files across, you know, your Ethernet or Wi-Fi or whatever, you can just grab the removable hard drive and move it between devices. Because Dmedia will still understand what files are on those drives, and the metadata all syncs up, so like, you know, Novacut edits and all that stuff will get synced. So yeah, I think it's done now. So now, if I unplug this local drive, it'll restart. It's a vigilance loop, I call it, and what it does, look at this. Now there's zero files with copies equals two. So that means everything's now brought up to three copies. So this month is the first release that all of these background behaviors have been turned on. The last one we turned on this month that was actually on for 1 month, we turned it back off and then back on again, is the copy decreasing behavior. So, you know, when you're working with big media sets, one of the issues is your drives constantly fill up and you need to delete stuff in order to make room for your new working set. But this is a super error prone thing for people to do and just kind of stressful and a pain. So that's one of the behaviors that we built into Dmedia. So as you're, you know, changing the data set you're working on, Dmedia will see, oh, I need free space. It'll only do this once it actually needs space. To say I need free space, and it'll figure out if there's any files that can be safely, that if it deleted those files, there's still three copies elsewhere. And it, you know, so it can constantly shuffle things around and adjust things to match what you're actually using. It also deletes the files according to the what you used the longest ago, you know, so like accessing the files keeps them on whatever drives you're accessing them from. So that's kind of the big deal. This month we still don't consider Dmedia production ready. You know, something I take very seriously, and you know, when I say production ready, I mean like I can sleep at night with the idea of people using Dmedia to store assets for, you know, $100 million movie. You know, that's the level of data safety we're striving for, which is why, again, you know, certain things in Dmedia I left kind of janky looking just because I didn't want people to have the wrong impression, because, you know, our promise is very big, and so I have to be careful not to get the wrong expectation. But anyway, next month, I think, and again, you know, if there's issues that come up, we're not going to rush this, but right, betting man, I think next month is going to be production ready, and that's super exciting for us. So anyway, thanks for watching, and just get in touch with us on, you know, IRC or Google+ or Twitter or Facebook or whatever if you have any questions, and have a good summer.